Hello world, it's Official Fun and Cream. In this tutorial I'll be showing how to edit your intro templates in Blender. This is a 2016 update and I really hope that I'll be able to help you guys out. So let's get started. So first you'll need to download a template. I offer many different templates. You could check them out. I put an annotation. You could also check in the description. So after downloading the template, you'll most probably find a zip file. Now, if you don't know how to unzip files, you could use the program called UNZIP. You could get a free trial. I also put all the links in the description, or you could get another free program called 7-Zip. So just click on it and then click on the Blender file and it will open up Blender. Okay, so now you opened the template. To edit the text, right click on the text and then press on tab on your keyboard and then press on backspace and then just write whatever you want. And then press on tab again and you'll be done. Now in this example, there's double layer of text, so you also need to edit the bottom layer of the text. The process is the same. Right click on it and then press tab, backspace, write whatever you want and then press tab again, and that's it. Now many of you guys asked me in my previous video how to make the text smaller if it appears huge. Now in the bottom right you'll be able to see a camera and a bunch of different icons. While right clicking on your text, go to the F symbol. Okay, so after that, go a little bit down and then you'll find size. Now you have to choose a number between 0 to 1. So for this example, I'm gonna be using 0.5 and then we're gonna see if we need to adjust it further. So you have to adjust the two layers. So right click on the top layer and also put 0.5. As you can see that the M is not on the screen and the F is also not on the screen. So it's not gonna show when you render it. I think 0.4 is so small. So we need a number between 0.5 and 0.4, which is 0.45. Now that's perfect. Adjust the second layer, 0.45 again, and here you go. Okay, so this looks good. Now we'll need to make sure that the text is inside the frame the whole time. So to do that, drag the green line to the beginning and then press play. You should probably hear some music. If you don't, then I made a tutorial on how to add music in Blender, so you could check it out. I put an annotation and also you'll find all the links in the description. So now we reach the final step, which is rendering. To do that, press on the camera icon. And then go a little bit down until you see output. Now this is the place where the video is going to save. Place it somewhere where you could easily find it. So I'm gonna place it in the desktop. When you're done, click on accept and the file will save here. Then we'll need to choose the output of the file. Under output, you'll find this drop down menu. Click on it and then if you have QuickTime, I suggest you click on that. However, many of you will probably not find QuickTime. So if you don't find QuickTime, you could click on etch.264. That format will also work perfectly. And if you don't have that, you have also MPEG. That's also good. Under encoding, you'll find format. You could pick QuickTime, etch.264, AVI, it doesn't matter, it can be anything. And then click on the codec, and also you could choose H.264. Go a little bit down until you find audio codec. This is the format that the music will be played in. Click on that and either choose MP3 or AAC. When you're done, go back up. You'll find resolution. The higher the resolution, the longer it takes for the file to render. However, the higher the resolution, the better the quality. So you could adjust it to the way you want. For this tutorial, I'm gonna keep it the same way. You could put it 1,700 or whatever. Sometimes it might take up to 2 hours for it to render, so I suggest you keep it overnight or when you're going to school. To check how the final output would look like, click on render. So this is how it's actually going to look like. If you want to know how to change the color of the background or change the font or the color of the text, I'll put some annotations. If you're happy and satisfied, click on animation and it will start rendering. Make sure to comment down below what Blender tutorials would you like to see next. And until next time, see ya!